Hello there, you're watching Proactive London. Coming up today, we have a presentation from Gravis explaining essentially how they look after people's money and aim to give them a positive return for when they most need it. Set up in 2008 at the height of the financial crisis, and today, of course, we find ourselves in a completely different type of crisis and how they're adjusting to that. They believe in long-term investment strategies. This is a presentation from Gravis here on Proactive London. Enjoy.
I think part of my job is to make a client understand that when they give me that pound that they've got, I'm going to look after it and I'm going to make it better. I'm going to try and give them a return positive over inflation. They don't often say, is it going in equities versus fixed rate? What's the yen against the dollar? They want me to take the money and make sure I'm looking after it and give them a positive return for when they're going to need it.
So when we set up Gravis in 2008, in the midst of the global financial crisis, investors were desperately seeking income. The founders of Gravis had met advising primarily corporate investors on assets in sectors like infrastructure, property and debt, but individuals couldn't really get access to these assets. So our business plan was very simple. It was to create funds that allowed individuals exposure to long-dated predictable cash flows.
I think there's no better time than the middle of the most appalling crisis to set up a business of the nature of Gravis. A lot of people would say that if you can survive from a starting point in the depths of such a crisis, then you can survive pretty much anything. It's informed the manner in which the business has developed, this focus on hard assets that we absolutely understand that deliver a decent risk-adjusted return. Those sort of qualities do not go out of fashion.
Voluntary Farm is a community farm for adults with special needs aged between the ages of 18 and 65, and it offers a number of facilities for them. The opportunity to be able to come on holiday here on respites and short breaks. We offer emergency placements as well, and we have the opportunity for clients to have lifelong tenancies, which is often very, very difficult, but they can stay here for the rest of their lives if they want to.
The investment itself obviously is based on a massive social impact. Obviously it's government funded. We're in the envious position of being effectively paid the rent directly by each local authority under safeguarding rules, so that we don't fall under universal credit, which somebody has then the ability to not pay the rent. That comes directly to us. So it's a long-term investment because we offer properties for life.
My son James, who's 19 and a half years old, was initially born healthy. And very, very quickly we realised that there were some serious issues with Jane's respiratory issues, and we unfortunately ended up at 9 months old being told that we had a brain dead child. You can only imagine the impact that had on my wife Julie and I. And, you know, learning to care for a son who's severely disabled has its challenges. We set the basis based on our own son about what we would want for James. I suppose as founders, Julie and I have always wanted to make sure that James has the best. And what we think is, if we can deliver that standard for our own son, hopefully everybody else will be impressed with those standards. So I think it's all about aiming to be outstanding in everything that you do and proving that, you know, with a bit of love and a bit of care, you can get there. All I would say to the investors is, it's that investment where you can lay your head down on the pillow at the end of the night thinking you've done something amazing, and knowing that that investment is going to help so many adults with special needs and get us off this foundation level, which is where we're at now. This dream has just started, to be fair, and the projects have started. It's that feel-good factor of not just a financial return back on that investment, but the good that it's making as well, where we wouldn't have been able to do it without the support of the investors. It's as straightforward and simple as that.
One of the things that struck me about working at Gravis is that the people there tend to combine an analytical forward way of thinking along with a real creativity and a real strive to want to find a better way of doing things, whether that's finding new fund structures or looking at new assets and sectors.
Escape Bloomsbury is a 430-bed purpose-built student accommodation facility here in central London, catering to students from across the world who want to live, work and study at some of the world-leading institutions that we have here in London.
It's really important for us to help students feel like this is their new home. We've got a lot of international students from all across the world, and it's really important for them to settle in London and then for them to feel like they've got a family at Scape.
One of the things that Gravis is well known for and that we look for is long-term investments, and student accommodation fits that really well because we know that students are always going to be looking to study in higher education, particularly in London, and in terms of looking at it as an investment, you know that you're looking at contracted cash flows over the next year, you know that there's that inbuilt demand that students are going to need somewhere to stay, and purpose-built student accommodation of the quality that we invest in, looking at Scape and looking what student living have in their portfolio, is the kind of assets that you know students will want to live in for a really long time to come.
It's not just the building, it's not just the room, it's the staff as well who care for the students. You've got 24-hour coverage, you've got 24-hour reception, and everything can be done through an app or a heartbeat on your portal. So it's really, really important that we keep building buildings like this because we want to help nurture and allow our students to thrive.
The world has changed dramatically in the last 5 years, where people are now saying, is the product I'm in sustainable? Does it have good governance? Does it have a social responsibility? It's becoming more prevalent that a client will say to you, where's it being? Is there any sort of child labour involved? Is there oil? Is there armaments? They want things that they think now, especially the younger generation, are very keen on where the money's being invested.
Solar energy is prime green energy. It's generated from a site, you don't have to transport it anywhere. The site, once it's up and running, is reasonably easy to maintain, and it's got longevity that will mean that the daylight comes, solar is generating energy for us.
We're a curtain solar farm. Today, this is one of 22 ground mount solar PV projects that Gravis own. That portfolio of projects generates enough electricity for approximately 40,000 households across the UK, their annual energy supply. Investing in solar is a smart move because it's very low maintenance. All you need is the daylight and the plant will start working. The revenues are government backed by a support mechanism, and it's good for the environment. On top of that, we're working towards trying to be net zero by 2050, and this is a project that's going to have a lifespan of 20-25 years, and is going to contribute towards hitting those targets.
The demands for energy are going to continue increasing, and we've got to find different ways of meeting that demand, and solar is a good clean energy for doing so.
And everyone cares about the environment. We're terribly scared about what we're doing to Mother Earth. And so as a consequence, I don't think that everything that we do is going to be environmentally focused, but I think investors are going to be more concerned about where their money is deployed. Where does it go? What they want to know is that their money hasn't been used to fund things that they fundamentally disagree with. And I think the world is generating a social conscience that is more powerful than probably any movement that we've seen today.
We're here today at Grange Farm, anaerobic digestion facility.
This is the very start of the process. This is our feedstock that we feed the cows on. It's a mix of grass silage and maize silage mixed together, which comes across here. Cows will come out shortly, they'll eat this material. Obviously, what goes in must come out, and what comes out is mixed with straw, which is their bedding. There's loads of energy in this stuff, and we can process this in the AD plant. This is what breaks down to make the energy, along with what the cows can't digest themselves. As well as the manures from over there, we've got energy crops that we've grown in the fields, that we've got in this clamp here that we've stored. And what we'll do is we'll take this, we'll mix it with the farmyard manure from the cattle we've just seen, and put it over here in the AD plant. This is the feed hopper. This is where we take the mixture of the energy crops and the cattle manure. We load them into here before going into the plant. This is what's called a solid feeder. It just augers the solid material straight into the tanks. These big green domes that you can see on top of the tanks here, this is where all the gas that's been produced from the process is being stored. It's like a bit of a reservoir for us. We can see you've got these stainless steel pipes where the gas comes out of the domes before going over into this engine where we burn it to turn it into electricity. So we get two products that come out of the back end of the anaerobic digestion plant. We have solid digestate, which is this material, and then we have a liquid digestate, which we have to then spread onto the land.
Anaerobic digestion and renewable energy in general is a good investment for Gravis. It has many benefits, as we know, but most recently something that really struck a chord with me was a survey in 2019 announced that there was over 450 operational AD plants in the UK that currently produce enough renewable energy to power 1 million homes.
My definition of remarkable would probably be different to somebody else's. It's to do the research about what your clients want. If the fund advertises its parameters, it's to stay within the parameters and to understand that the clients often just want safety, security, and the knowledge that what you've told them the fund is going to do is actually going to try and achieve it.
I think that when the vast majority of people invest £100 of their hard-earned money, they're not looking for it to double in value overnight. I think primarily they want it to not lose value, but to get a fair return for the risk that they're taking. And it may sound cliched, but I think that most people are looking for investments that are going to allow them to sleep peacefully at night.
What I suspect will never go out of fashion is the appetite of investors for hard assets. Assets that are relatively easy to understand, assets that have a demonstrable value. That will always remain fashionable.